Hi, everyone, and welcome to SC20. I'm Trish Damkroger, VP and GM of High Performance Computing at Intel. Supercomputing is my favorite show of the year, where I get to reconnect with friends, partners, and customers. While this year definitely looks different, I'm still excited about seeing some familiar faces through the many different virtual programs and meetings. And today, I'm excited to talk with you about how high-performance computing is at the center of data transformation and the convergence of AI. Today, the criticality of time to insight is especially relevant to each of our lives. As we are currently living in this COVID world, the days that pass without a proven vaccine are having life or death impact every minute, every day. The need to find cleaner energy sources to save the planet becomes more apparent every day. Our ability to accurately predict weather patterns for real-time events like hurricanes and forest fires has been relevant every day. These examples and so many more generate a mass amount of data and will take an enormous amount of compute to turn that data into insights and predictions and then into actions to save lives. High-performance computing sits at the center of it all, processing the mathematical calculations, modeling and simulations to solve these complex problems. We are also seeing growth in AI workflows and a convergence of HPC and AI, where HPC systems are processing more data and AI is helping us make sense of the data quicker. Exascale systems being designed today will enable future innovations and discoveries across a wide range of fields. And even beyond exascale, neuromorphic and quantum computing systems will further push these boundaries of what is possible. But right now, today, our customers are using the latest Intel products, Xeon processors, and AI technologies to advance science and research and bring faster time to insight. Don't just take my word for it. Let's hear directly from a few of our customers.
Hi, Trish. It's great to see you again, even though it's only virtually. Again, I want to thank you for the opportunity to speak with you at today's talk. As you're all aware, with the recent Crossroads announcement, Los Alamos is very excited to be partnering again with Intel. We're also excited to be introducing new technologies. One of those is the new Intel Sapphire Rapids processor. With that, along with future memory capabilities, Crossroads is going to deliver a significant increase in performance and capability over our Trinity system. Crossroads will be a significant asset to the Department of Energy in being able to help manage the nation's nuclear stockpile. And we're also pleased to be another partner along with other DOE facilities with Intel in solving some of the nation's most difficult physics and engineering questions. So, again, thank you for the opportunity to be here today, and I'm looking forward to a long partnership now and in the future. Thank you.
So, hello, Tris. At Barcelona Supercomputing Center, we have a long tradition, a long experience collaborating with Intel. We are very happy. And not just collaborating in research, but using the digital machines as the base for our supercomputer, Mare Nostrum 3, Mare Nostrum 4. Now we have several open projects. One of them, one of the most important, is how we can increase the performance of executing some high-performance computer application when they run in architecture having heterogeneous memory. Obviously, we are doing that with the processor, Xeon processor, and the Optane persistent memory from Intel, trying to reduce the execution time and reducing the overall energy we need to execute these workflows. In some cases, we are able to get even twice the performance of the original one. So we are very happy with our results, and we will continue in this collaboration. Please, I wish you a very good supercomputing conference.
Thanks, Trish, and hello to everyone at SC20. At Liquid, we help customers build agile, scalable, and better utilized systems with our unique multi-fabric composable infrastructure platform for dynamic AI workloads. A few weeks ago, we announced we'll be providing the world's largest composable supercomputer for the U.S. Department of Defense's HPC modernization program. Intel is a key partner in this effort. The Xeon Platinum 9200 CPU with deep learning boost technology will ensure we're able to meet the DoD's most demanding artificial intelligence application requirements. We're looking forward to collaborating with Intel, the DoD team, as well as their counterparts in the public sector to deliver a historic AI-centric HPC purpose-built system that's built to solve the country's most urgent problems. Thank you and have a great SC20.
As you saw with some of our customer stories, the convergence of HPC and AI is happening now. It is taking many different forms and helping scientists uncover new, more meaningful insights faster than ever. For instance, we are seeing that AI is being integrated into HP workflows to accelerate things like pattern detection. And in some cases, AI models are replacing physics-based models altogether. And AI models complement more traditional HPC solutions to reveal insights faster and more comprehensively than data processing and analytics-based applications can be by themselves. We are seeing this convergence happening across a broad range of industries with one primary goal of AI accelerating insights that have been traditionally done fully by HPC. Workload diversity is not just an HPC phenomenon or an AI phenomenon. We see it across all workloads. Traditional modeling and simulation workloads have predominantly involved optimizations for scalar and vector math computations. AI, on the other hand, is not a single monolithic workload and is still evolving, requiring a broader architectural capability, incorporating optimizations for matrix and spatial math. In addition, the expansion of HPC from the edge through client to data centers and cloud infrastructure will require enabling a multifaceted approach. A one-size-fits-all solution will not provide the right power, compute, or latency options required to build optimized solutions customers demand. As we saw earlier, Barcelona Supercomputing Center is a great example of an exascale lab accelerating HPC applications using heterogeneous memory applications. Intel's XPU strategy brings a diverse mix of scalar, vector, spatial, and matrix architectures deployed in a range of silicon platforms such as the CPU, GPU, FPGA, and specialized accelerators, and supported by an open, industry standard, unified programming model to simplify application development and portability. Intel offers the most flexible and performance-optimized portfolio of products, from multipurpose CPUs to AI-optimized discrete ASICs. Customers can tackle HPC and AI workloads with Intel Xeon Scalable Processors, Xeon Core CPUs, and Intel FPGAs, down to low-power Intel Movidius VPUs today. As the proven foundation for HPC, Intel Xeon processors will continue to be the workhorse for the most demanding and AI-infused workloads. But as the demand for compute continues to grow, and as workloads grow more diverse, there is a need to complement the CPU platform with XPU acceleration to meet every customer's computing requirements. Intel is committed to taking a software-first approach that delivers a unified and scalable abstraction for heterogeneous architectures. And finally, storing and moving complex large data sets across compute domains with low latency brings system complexities that require next-generation memory and interconnect technologies that Intel has been innovating and investing in as well. The convergence of HPC and AI is a critical inflection point for the HPC industry, and no company is better positioned to enable our customers to leverage this paradigm. The Intel Xeon Scalable Processor is the only data center CPU optimized for the convergence of HPC and AI, with AVX 512 vector SIMD extensions to accelerate HPC applications, the Intel DL Boost technology to accelerate AI applications, with VNNI instructions more specifically accelerating inference applications in the Cascade Lake processors we are shipping today. Intel Optane persistent memory is supported on the Cascade Lake processors to accelerate data analytics and AI applications, while driving key functions like accelerated checkpointing and boot up in HPC systems. Now, let's take a closer look at Ice Lake. The third-generation Xeon Scalable Processor for HPC will deliver advanced performance for a range of workloads. We're increasing memory bandwidth from 6 to 8 channels Great news for users in areas like computational fluid dynamics, where many applications use every bit of that bandwidth to feed their jobs. With the new Sunny Cove Core architecture, users will see up to an 18% higher instruction per clock versus previous generations. And that increase pays dividends, for example, with applications like NAMD and many others that take advantage of our AVX 512 support. Ice Lake is our first Xeon scalable processor with PCI Gen 4 for faster I/O, as well as support for Intel SGX. If you're interested in learning more about that, be sure to catch our SC20 Tech Talk on Ice Lake by Irma Esmer. So, what does all this mean for HPC users? While we won't be disclosing full Ice Lake specs and performance results until launch, I can tell you today that we're seeing competitive advantage with Ice Lake on key life science and financial service applications, including LAMPS and NAMD molecular dynamic workloads and Monte Carlo simulations. As you can see, we're achieving leadership performance with just half the cores. I can't wait to bring this product to market. If you have questions about what you're seeing here, be sure to join our live chats in the Intel SC20 virtual booth. With the groundbreaking new capabilities I just described, it's no wonder we're seeing customers so excited about Ice Lake. We're very happy to announce this week that KMA will be adopting Ice Lake for its supercomputer number 5 in January 2021. This system will deliver theoretical performance of 50 petaflops, 8 times faster than KMA's current supercomputer. This level of performance is essential for the range of first-rate services KMA delivers, including weather prediction, climate change assessment, earthquake, and marine studies. We're also thrilled that the Max Planck Computing and Data Facility has chosen Ice Lake for their new Raven system. And Oracle will deploy their Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, leveraging the computing performance of Ice Lake, and is expecting a 30% performance increase on certain workloads such as CFD, EDA, and crash. These are amazing results, and we can't wait to hear about how Ice Lake will meet your broad spectrum of workloads and performance needs. Our Xe architecture is the foundation that helps us build GPUs that are scalable from teraflops to petaflops. The Xe architecture represents Intel's transition from an architecture designed solely for the needs of a power and area constrained integrated graphics to fully scalable graphics architecture that will scale exponentially to serve many markets, spanning from integrated graphics and entry-level discrete to high-end gaming and data center graphics. XELP is focused on the thin and light mobile market with great performance per watt. XeHPG is a gaming and cloud graphics optimized GPU. XeHP combines high performance AI type computing with media computing. And XeHPC, the architecture behind the GPU codenamed Ponte Vecchio, is designed to deliver breakthrough AI and HPC performance on our exascale computing platforms. Intel has invested in integrated graphics for more than a decade, and we are currently used by over 1 billion users to power a wide range of client applications. To talk about how we simplify development across multiple types of processors and accelerators, I'd like to welcome my friend, VP and GM of Data Center XPU Products and Solutions at Intel, Jeff McVeigh.
Great. Thank you, Trish. It is so great to be here to talk about the important value of software to delivering those insights. As we know, the software stack is built on a number of layers, from applications and workloads where data scientists and other developers typically operate. They utilize middleware and frameworks like TensorFlow, PyTorch, high-level languages like Python at scale and Julia at scale, and lower-level languages like Fortran and C++. And the layers of the abstraction of the software stack allow for reuse and bringing those capabilities more quickly to market. And really where OneAPI plays is at this lower level of the stack that fits underneath middleware and frameworks so that we can take code that is already running on CPUs and quickly bring those to other architectures with very minimal, if any, code changes for people that live and operate in higher levels of the stack. This allows for really freedom of choice from the technical and financial barriers that proprietary solutions supporting accelerated computing do today. We do this by exposing the latest cutting-edge features of that hardware technology, expose that through the stack, but also while building upon the existing HPC programming models of OpenMP, Fortran, and MPI. And a critical aspect of this is that it's an industry standards. It's also based on open specifications so that any vendor can implement the same capabilities and provide those to the developers on top of it. We've been working on OneAPI for a few years within Intel and launched and announced our public intentions at this time last year at SE19. We launched and announced the industry initiative, the first version of our beta product, and then also the dev cloud. And then through that time, over the past 12 months, we've been very active internally and working with the ecosystem to evolve the capabilities of the specification. We've now just in September of this year launched the 1.0 version. We've also gone through a progression of a variety of beta product releases that add more features, performance, support for a broader set of architectures. And we're really excited also about the engagement by the ecosystem to utilize what we're providing, giving us feedback and helping us to enhance that, and then also taking that and extending it even further than we ever thought. CodePlay, for example, bringing the support of OneAPI to NVIDIA GPUs. University of Heidelberg signing up to be a center of excellence to bring the same support to AMD GPUs, and really showing that this is a full-on industry-wide opportunity. And I'm also really excited to announce that December of this year, we'll be releasing the gold version of the OneAPI toolkits, which is really the productization of that specification for Intel's platforms, bringing product-level quality and performance. All of these build upon the heritage of our HPC tools, Parallel Studio XE, our high-performance compilers, libraries, analysis tools, and expanding those capabilities across that XPU spectrum. All this is available for free and can run either locally or within our developer cloud or dev cloud. And our dev cloud is really important today as we're doing everything from home, as we know. It's really important to be able to access new hardware, to do that without a lot of installation hassles, to do that without configuration. And this developer sandbox has support for our Xeon CPUs, our FPGAs. Recently, we've had limited access to some of our discrete GPUs and are now broadening that up where all of our Iris Xe Max discrete GPUs are available for all developers. And then also bringing out our Xe HP high-performance discrete GPUs for early access developers, which are also now deployed at Argonne Labs. So with all of this, we're super excited about the opportunities that OneAPI can deliver for developers, the entire ecosystem, and really enabling us to get faster time to those insights to deliver better value for you and your customers. And with that, I'll hand it back to you, Trish.
Thank you, Jeff. With the power to perform over a quintillion or a billion billion calculations per second, exascale computing will make time to insight lightning fast. And Intel and the U.S. Department of Energy are committed to deliver the Aurora Exascale supercomputer at DOE's Argonne National Laboratory in 2022. This collaboration will focus on creating next-generation semiconductor technologies, manufacturing processes, advanced system design and software enablement, including future silicon development, future architectures for high-performance computing and AI, and software ecosystem enablement for exascale computing. Aurora will give scientists and researchers an unprecedented set of tools and applications that will enable breakthrough advancements in a wide variety of areas that will benefit all of us, including medicine, weather modeling, climate change, and material science. The future extends beyond exascale, and Intel is excited to be at the forefront of these projects and partnerships. Intel recently announced a 3-year agreement with Sandia National Labs to explore the value of neuromorphic computing for scaled-up computational problems. Sandia will use Intel's 50 million neuron Lohihi-based system and will lay the foundation for our largest neuromorphic research system, which could exceed more than 1 billion neurons in computational capacity. Intel recently released a 100 million neuron system, POIKI, Springs, to the Intel neuromorphic research community to demonstrate how neuromorphic computing can provide up to 4 orders of magnitude better energy efficiency for constraint satisfaction. Intel and Sandia hope to advance research in scaled-up neuromorphic computing to determine where these systems are most effective and how they can provide real-world value. Beyond Aurora, Intel, Argonne National Labs, and the Department of Energy have entered into a long-term agreement to further support the United States leadership in advanced computing systems. Intel plans to provide QNX research partners access to the entire quantum full-stack system, from qubit devices to the hardware and the software required to control these devices to quantum algorithms that will harness the power of quantum technologies. There is so much to see and talk about this year at SC20. We've posted talks, fireside chats, and demos on these topics at the Intel HPC and AI Pavilion site. Be sure to check those out. It's an exciting time to be in tech and to be able to be a part of the amazing technological advances happening at Intel. And with that, I hope you all have a great SC20, and I hope to see you in person next year. Stay safe and healthy.